Yes, on the chat window, if you can all hear me fine. Yes, all good? Okay, great, great, very good. So, hello everyone. So first things first, has everybody managed to install TopCat? Is it running for everyone? I can't hear any voices.
Yes.
No. Okay, fine. Maybe that is a bit in here. So it's running for everybody. Nobody has an installation problem, right? You just need your Java running and you need this to run, right? Okay. Next step is that, can everybody access data? Like I told you, you can even make a plain text ASCII file for yourself, which you use from TopCat. So can you all import the data file into TopCat? If you make a, if you just make a basic, a text file which has data, like I think I showed you last time, can you actually import your data? Okay, so importing data is fine. So let's start with the problem of Rohit Sachdev. Histogram plots don't show up. Okay, so let me just import some data. I'll load some data over here. Should we go back to Messier 3? Is everybody using the Messier 3 data? M3 data. So if you all have it, should I share it? I'll just check. If you all don't have it, I can share it. M3.
Ma'am, we cannot see you or the share screen.
Okay, thanks. Yeah, so I'll just share screen. Just open my share screen. So does it says you've disabled. How do you attach? I'm giving them that data file. I'm saying share screen. Okay. I'm sharing the whole desktop one. So no problem. Now, can you all see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, good. I reckon you can unmute all of them because there are only 10 of them.
You can unmute whenever they want.
So you all can all unmute, like you are Mritika, right? I think you are the one talking. So you unmute yourself whenever you want, because there are not too many of you all. So we can, there's no problem.
Unmute, and when you are finished, you can mute it again.
Because otherwise there will be interference of signal. So does everybody have the M3 file? I've shared it on the chat window in case you don't have it. So I'll start with Rohit's question on histogram plots, right? So histogram is very simple. So you're seeing this. This is the histogram plot icon. Okay. So click on this. And once you click on this, you have to here select which is the parameter which you want to go for the histogram. So here it's, for example, with the RA, right? So this is the peak coming with the RA. You can also have an option of putting weights. Okay. So for example, typically you can, if you have errors, right? For example, if I was using parallax, here in this data file, I don't have parallax errors. This is a very simple data file. But supposing if you have the errors, right? You can use that in a smart way so that you put a difference of weight on your data points depending upon the errors in them. What happened?
Priya ma'am.
Yeah, tell me.
Yes, Rohit. When I click on the histogram plot, nothing shows up, no window opens.
No, but that means maybe you don't have any data file. Do you have a data file?
I clicked on M3.
And is the M3 highlighted?
Yes, the M3 is highlighted. Even I tried it for the test file.
Huh.
Even for the test file, it doesn't open up.
No, no, it should. So just share your screen. Na? And are you using Windows or Linux?
I'm using Linux. I'm watching on my desktop and my screen is on laptop. So
okay, so you're using the Linux version. Okay, so there's a slight difference, but this should not happen. But anyway, so tell me, show me your screen. I don't know why this should happen because it never happens. I'm not seeing this. Let's see. Show me your screen.
I don't think so. I'll be able to share the screen because I'm working on my laptop and I'm watching this on desktop. So I have to open it again on laptop and share the screen.
Why don't you focus your camera on your laptop? Let's see whether we can see it.
Okay.
Just hold your laptop in front of your thing, your desktop, wherever you are.
Just one minute. Let me just make it.
No, but I can't read here. I can't read anything.
Yeah, so.
Sorry. Eyesight is not so good. I have specs. I can wear them. But I don't know whether that will help.
Does it have anything to do with the graphics or something in my laptop?
It should not. I don't know. Actually, this is a question to ask Mark Taylor because I have never come across such a problem. So what happens? Acha, can you do this other plot, the scatter plot? Can you do it? The thing with the icon after histogram, that is for, it's called plane plotting window, which is basically scatter plot.
No, nothing opens. But when I go to graphics from this file menu, just next.
Yeah,
to
the screen, correct.
And then there is an option called histogram plot. Then in parentheses, it's old.
Huh.
Yeah. So when I click on that, the old one. Some opens, but the plot doesn't show up.
Okay, still the plot doesn't show up.
Yeah.
No, so actually this, what he did is some people like the older versions because of certain features in them. So what he did is that he actually added these older versions of some of these things on this. So this is the older version of histogram. This one is the newer version of histogram.
Okay.
There's a slight difference in these, but he's just kept it just for people's convenience. But you're saying neither of them. So yeah, histogram plot old is here. Try this one. Try histogram plot old.
It doesn't. Window opens, but the plot doesn't show.
Acha, what kind of a laptop do you have? What are you using?
It's Dell.
Acha, nee, what processor does it have? What RAM
does
it
have? i5. Intel i5.
Okay, then it should be fine.
If your other graphics are working, then there's no problem with your Linux. Then if there was a problem, it should have created problem for everything.
No, but he's saying you're saying your normal graphics is also not giving you plot. Supposing from graphics you click and you click on say sky plot or view plot, nothing works.
So if I click on graphics and I click on the 2D plot, old one.
Huh.
Yeah, then it shows.
Okay. 2D old shows. But the upper ones, which is sky plot, view plot, sphere plot, none of them work.
No. So should I download it again or something?
I think that's a good idea. I think download it again.
Full,
download the full version.
Yeah. Is there a light version?
So I just, while downloading TopCat, what I did is I opened my terminal and downloaded from there. I did not use the website.
And go to the website.
And did you do it as sudo?
Yeah,
sudo. You did it as sudo. Okay.
Yes.
No. Better you go to the website. And there are two files. One is TopCat Lite, one is full.
Okay.
Take the full one. And then you run it with Java minus jar.
Okay.
Yeah. So better.
So while this session is going on, just download it. And then we'll come back to you if you still have problems with it. Okay.
All right, ma'am. I'll do
so
that.
Till then, let's see other people. Others, please tell us what are your issues. And.
Ma'am, what have you used as your size, radius size? Because my histogram is looking very different from yours for the same case.
Okay,
same
okay.
Problem, ma'am.
Okay, so this is for M3?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, because mine is looking much broader than yours is looking very narrow. Mine is more like a very broad curve.
So then what was the radius you took? I'll just now tell you what was the radius I took. If I actually...
took two.
Two what? Degrees?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So 2 degrees is very huge, because the thing is that M3 is at a distance of about 10.5 kpc. Okay, it's quite far away from us. So if you were to measure and get its angular size, most star clusters fit in 10 arc minutes. Okay, but they are closer. This is a globular cluster. This is further, right? Okay. So you have taken, so mine, if you see my size, if you see over here, maximum and minimum, you can see it over here. It's coming, you can see my screen, right? So you're saying it's 0.8. 0.8 degrees or 0.7 degrees, because you have in the RA you can see it's 0.17 and 92, right? So it's like it's less than, it's 0.7. So you take 0.7, multiply that by 60. So you
take
0.7 multiplied by 60, it's 42 minutes I've taken or whatever, but in short, you have taken 2 degrees, is very large. That, so that basically you're getting a very large part of the sky. So if you, no. The difference in degrees is 0.7, right? So we multiplied in 60 to get it in arc minutes. So 42 is in arc minutes, obviously. And so what you should do is obviously take a smaller size, but if you go through the normal cleaning process, which I was telling you, like for example, once you do your proper motion plot, do your proper motion plot. That means plot PM RA versus PM DEC. Okay. Plot that. And you'll see that you will get a very big blob. And for you to identify the other blob, which belongs to the cluster, will be maybe a little tougher. So then when you clean up, na, then it doesn't make a difference if you had taken that larger size. It's not such a big issue. So let me just. So here you take this, you can expand your scale. So now you see that since I've taken a smaller size, you see the center of my blob, is coming here at -0.2 and -2.6, which is clearly not 0, 0. Right, you may have a bigger blob near 0, 0 and a smaller blob over here. Please plot and see, na Gitanjali. Just plot and share.
So, yes, ma'am.
So you'll get a big blob at 0, 0, a bigger, denser one, and you'll have a smaller one at this other location, which is the globular.
Yeah, ma'am, I'll do that. I'll do that.
So just do that and share your screen.
Ma'am, I'll have to. I won't share. I'll face my camera towards that because.
Again, using two
devices.
So what you do is make it a whatever GIF file or whatever. Take a screenshot. So you can take an. There's an export plot to.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you just take a screenshot only, and we can see it. But that's what's going to happen for you. Since you've taken a larger area, you'll get that 0, 0 wala blob, and you'll get this other blob which will be smaller. So it is okay, because if you, for example, if you take a normal object, you don't know its distance, right? So from the beginning, how is it going to dawn upon you that you should take so and so size? So it's okay if you take an arbitrary size, and then when you see it in the plot, you will be able to realize that you needed a smaller one. Because let's minimize our assumptions. Let's not assume, right? So you take a size and so just plot and show.
Yeah, I'll do that, ma'am. And ma'am, one more thing that I wanted to ask is how to choose subsets. I couldn't get it last time when you showed.
Subsets are very simple. One way is visually. For example, this is the blob, now. So click on subsets. You can draw a subset region. So for example, if I decide these many objects is what I'm going to call my cluster, right?
Yes.
By marking it, I clicked on it, finished drawing region, and I call it C. So now I say, okay, this is my subset. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
This is
But
similarly, you can even do that with histograms. You know, if you did a histogram, and in a histogram also, when you plotted the histogram, say this is the histogram, right, for RA. Now, what I think is obviously these objects are probably not part, right? So I basically want to take from, say, this size to this size, right? So then I can also take a subset from this thing. Only problem is that in histogram, it takes subset from visible. So or if I make subset from visible, it's going to take all. So I'll have to go into axis, and I'll have to go into range, and I'll have to reduce my range, right? Okay. Decide what range. So I don't want these. This is all the tail. So I want to stop it, say, at a little bit beyond 205.65, supposing. So this point. So I will just take it something like this, right? And then I decide that this is my part, which I'm going to take, the absolute central part, okay? If you want, you can even scale it up like this, okay? So this will be my central part. Now I call this my subset. So let me call this C2, for example, okay? Now, if I want to compare, right? I can do the same plot. If you see, this is this. I put my subsets. I'm taking all in C2. And now here, when you say plot, you say rescale, okay? So when I say rescale, now you can see that this pink part was the whole thing. And this this purple part was the part that I took as this. So I can still say, okay, oh, maybe I didn't take everything properly, right? So I can revise it. In the sense, I can go back to my all plot, right? I can switch off. See, these are switches. I can switch off C2, okay? I switch it off and I go back to my thing because I feel that I should have, supposing I decide that I should take my C2 from 205.4 till 205.7, supposing, okay? So I may do it like that and I may go back to my axis and I may take this so that I take it from 205.4 and 205.7, supposing. I decide to take all that, right? Now I can say take subset from visible. I can give it the same name, overwrite it. I can say now take C2, okay? Now I can replot it with the rescaled version. So now you see that I have taken these, only these guys, without taking these wings, right?
Yeah,
but right, both right. These methods, you see, are just visual ones. There is no scientific analysis or justification for why am I cutting it over here or cutting it over here, right?
Yeah.
So the other smarter way to do it, so one way is to do it like this. Other way is that you actually use the stats, for example. I may look at the stats. So for example, if I take parallax, okay? Parallax is a measure of the distance. So now you can see my mean parallax is 0.07. The standard deviation is 1.5, right? And this is this. So you can, oh, this is coming for C2. Let us take it for all. So when you put all, you can put over here and you say recalculate. So it recalculates it. Now what happens is my parallax is 0.08. But you see your standard deviation is so large. It's so much more larger than your parallax, right? So if I want to decide where do I put my cutoff, for my parallax, supposing, so ideally you'll take it as 3 times, say your standard deviation or something like that, but I can't take it like that because here you see my standard deviation is very, very large, right? So I can't do it with that. I should have a much more clean sample. Here you can see, look at your right ascension, my standard deviation is 0.08, okay? So if I want, see, obviously there's going to be a lot of contamination in this because there can be stars in that region which do not belong. But if I take that for my whole sample, my standard deviation is so much, right? Then I can, supposing if I take, I need to know what width should I take, right? For this, whatever function I'm taking, if I'm taking center is here, I need to know how much width to take. So one standard way is you take the width to be 3 times the standard deviation. So if my standard deviation is 0.08, I multiply that into 3, right? So I get 0.2. So then I take it 205. So supposing I, one way of doing it is I take it, this is when you put a function. So now here I say a new subset, and here I'll say this C3. And here what you need to remember is what is the name of this column. This column is called RA. So now I can say I'll take my RA. If I'm taking the mean to be 205.549, okay? So I take my RA to be greater than this minus 3 times the standard deviation. So say minus 2. So it should be greater than 2.5, 0.3, supposing. I'm just roughly saying this is 0.2, this is 0.5. So it should be greater than that. And RA should be less than, I'm making the width, right? So 0.5 plus 0.2. So it should be less than 205.7, right? So now what you see, I've taken it as though the center of this thing is 205.5, and I've given it a width of 0.2. So that means now I'm taking the RAs which are greater than 0.3 and less than 0.7, correct? and I'm defining it to be that. Okay, so I'm taking this definition and I took with this. So now what happens when I take this thing which you see, where is my plot? This is my plot. You can see now here, I'll put this with my C3. So you can see my C3 is clearly taken from this size to this size. Now you can already see over here that my thing is slightly lopsided, right? I've got more on this side and more on that side. So that's not a very good idea. In short, my center was not well selected. So my center would have been better as 205.55, right? So I can revise this and go as this. So I can take it 3.5 and I take it 6.5. I do it like, and you see, this immediately shows up on this, on my histogram plot. My change will show up. It should show up. But in short, you will, in this kind of doing stats, you can use a more, what do you say, mathematical definition as to why. So the stats aren't coming to good because I should be more smart in calculating my center and doing this. And another big problem in this is we are only doing it cutoff in terms of RA. If we do the cutoff also in terms of DEC. So here if I add off, I add another thing where I add this for, I'll add this over here and do this. I just made this picture. I do this here for, no, this is okay, no table. So I'm adding one more plot and in this plot, I'm taking my same table and here I'm taking it in terms of DEC. Now you see DEC ka difference is so much. So I won't put them on the same plot. Let me remove this. I won't put this here. Okay. So if we do it in terms of DEC, this is the plot in terms of DEC. Let me, I will rescale it. So this is now in terms, oh no, this was RA. This is RA. So I want to make it in terms of DEC. Okay, it's, one second. The whole thing went. 1 minute. So now we are doing only the RA cut. So now let's try to do the cut in terms of DEC. So this is my DEC thing. Okay. So now I need to choose in terms of DEC, how do I choose the membership? Again, I will choose which is my center. So if you want, we can take this thing again. You can see your DEC center is 28.3. This is your standard deviation. So again, we can take 0.2 and 28.3. So now if I go back to this thing, you see my CA is this and my RAs and DECs are this. Again, you'll have to put an ampersand and you'll say your DEC, I think is called DEC only, no? So DEC greater than, 28.1, I'll put 28.1 and big less than 28.5. Okay. So now what has happened is, let us look at this over here. If I see the plot over here, this is the whole cluster, right? And now if you see my C3, oh, this is the part I've taken. So you can see how wrongly or how badly this has been selected. So what you need to do is, so it's not a one-step process, you know, you have to do it iteratively. You may do one thing, then realize that this is not fitting in nicely, right? So now looking at this plot, you may decide how to change your values. So here you can see the row subsets. So we can decide that, okay, my RA, I should have probably 205.4 would have been good enough. So I'll change this to 0.4, right? This is okay. In my DEC, I've taken this and this I should have taken 28.2 would have also been okay. So ideally, it should immediately, earlier it used to immediately react. Sometimes nowadays it doesn't. So let me just check, I'm replotting it so that it can now, okay. Now you see, this is the better C3 we've taken. But you can further improvise on this. Like in this, I've taken a rectangular structure, right? You can instead convert it so that you're getting a radial structure by, like putting more complex equations in the sense, you take an x squared plus y squared less than r squared, right? So you decide which is your x naught, y naught, which one is your radius, right? And accordingly, you get the shape to be more circular and not a rectangular shape. So there are very many ways to play around with this so that you get something more effective. But since you can immediately visualize what you've plotted, right, you can see that better. But for example, if we plot this, we already did that PMRA deck curve, right? So if I do, for example, PMRA deck here, right, you can clearly see in this one also, now we put my subsets. This is my C3. So you see the C3 has covered a lot of this part, right? If I were to take C2, which is an earlier one, we had this much, which is quite similar to C3. C was the one we took like this, so you can take this. C was what we did manually. So that's why we had a smaller one, right? So in short, what has to be done is, like I said, it's not a linear process where you start and, you know, this is the recipe, you do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, you will make some marking also, you will make some selection in the sense, you know, here you're doing cutoffs to get your subsets. Then you may visualize it and you may realize that your cutoff is not so good, you know, like it's coming to be something like this. You would like something slightly different. You can fit this to any kind of a function. For example, we needn't, just to give you an idea of, obviously your clusters are not a group which is sitting inside something, right? There will be some stars which are even further away, which could be members. So you could fit this to a Gaussian profile also, for example, by effectively adding the function when you're putting your row subset. Na? Here you can add in your function. So you decide what is your standard deviation, right? And just with an exponential function, you can characterize it, for example, with a Gaussian also, right? And so it, like specifically in the case of these clusters, there is an interplay of the physical location, number one, number two of the velocities, and number three of the distances. So you have to play around with all these three parameters, right? Because there can be, if you're taking spatial position, there can be stars which are the same spatial position but not members. Similarly, there can be stars which are moving with the same velocity and are not members. Similarly, there can be stars which are the same distance which are also not members. So you have to iteratively play around with all these things so that you get a good value. So for example, I'll just end my this part with this thing. And now if I take a sky plot of this. Okay, let me take the sky plot of this. And if I take this in terms of my RA deck, right? Now what you see is here, if I took the form which I showed you all, I take the sky vector. So all these are getting replaced by sky vectors. Where my sky vectors are a function of the proper motion, right? So these are these. Then like I told you, you have to rescale these because these go totally out of control. So let us rescale it and reduce these. Now when you see in terms of subsets, when you see it, this is how my C3 looks. So you can clearly see that in C3, there is a lot of contamination. Because that we took it by spatial, right? By spatial, by RA deck. Comparatively, if I take C was taken using the proper motion plot. You can see C in comparison. Let me make this all a lighter color. Yeah. And let me slightly. Okay, even C has a lot of contamination. Wasn't C taken from the proper motion plot? C should have lesser contamination. Let me check.
No, ma'am, I think you took C from RA deck only.
Ah, okay. Because then which one was from this thing?
C2. Ma'am, that was when we were looking at histogram. Then that was...
Then it got overwritten only.
Yeah.
Okay. Because now if I take the one which is with... okay. So if I now take the one, let me take that one only now once again. I'll just take that just so that it looks nice and we are happy. So let's look at this. Now I'll take a very conservative plot. I'll just take the central part of this thing and I'll say CPM. Okay. So now you'll see that in this plot, where is this one? If you see CPM, there are so many coming. Remove all. CM should be better behaved. It is not. What? CPM should be better behaved. They are kind of aligned this direction, but there's still a lot of scatter. So you have to check that out and see that. So I see there's a question by, Gitanjali, so play around with it.
Yes, and, ma'am.
Like I said, it's not a single answer. That's the fun of it, that it's not a recipe which you just follow. You have to go back and forth and do it. There's another question from, where was that thing? Mrinalini. Mrinalini is asking me, how do you save? Saving is very simple. It is called export. So saving is called export. So you say export your, you say export your file. I'll just move this thing. Export plot to a file. And you have a choice also whether you want it to be a JPEG, PDF, whatever style you want it to be. It will save it in whatever format you want and give it to you like that, right? And so what you can actually do is with these figures, you have a lot of this thing. You can play with, for example, there is the legend, which is, this is called the legend. So you can, if you want, you can remove this legend, right? You can also, you have a lot of freedom. For example, your axis, you can change the font, you can change the labels which you have, you know, this is the font which is there. You can reduce this font size, right? You can make your plots, what we call in scientific jargon, publishable quality, right? So earlier the TopCat plots used to look very, very sketchy. They didn't look so good. But nowadays what happens is because you have a lot of freedom, in the kind of text you want to do, you can even use tech fonts and stuff like that. And you can actually get it to look pretty nice, right? So nice that you otherwise what happens, you need to use Matplotlib or you need to use some other software in order to make your plot look good enough for publishing purposes. But now with this, you can do many things. So for example, this grid can be removed. If you don't want a grid, you can remove the grid. You want to keep the grid, you keep the grid. On the axis, you can also, you can put the whatever borders you want for the frame. You can add legends if you want. You can add, labels, right? So your labels also can be added. Thank you. And another thing actually which I haven't spoken to you about is that actually you can also use something called stills with which you can use coding to run TopCat. So TopCat runs in the background and then you code and you can put these things. But I don't use stills myself, so I don't know that very well. One can ask Mark Taylor about, but you can look over here. See, this is telling you, this is a very good thing. It's actually telling you the commands you are giving in stills to run this. So you can see here, look over here at this window. When I click on stills, it tells me TopCat stills, plot to sky, X pixels so much, Y pixels so much, font size is so much. It continues. See, it's telling you what is the whole code, right? So in principle, TopCat can also be run in a command line mode, not with these clicking of icons. You run it in command line using what is called stills. And a good way to learn stills is because TopCat actually gives you the stills commands. So for this very plot, you can see that I have the stills commands over here, right? So I can save these stills commands, right? Keep it with me. And if I want to adjust, supposing I want to change my font size to 12, I can directly change it from this and run it, right? So you can also run TopCat from command line mode. But like I said, since I don't use it much, I use a more conventional method in the sense I use TopCat to visualize the data, see what it's like, what do I want. And then I use Matplotlib to actually give me my plots, right? Because earlier, like I said, the plots which were from these were not so good. You needed to do it with Matplotlib. And those were good quality plots which were publishable. But now Stills is also there. You can even ask Mark about Stills and check with him. But like I said, for all the plots, you get the Stills code. So you can always use this code to, to actually improvise on your still skills. And it's very intuitive. Like you look at the commands, you can clearly see what means what. Right. Yeah. So who else has a question? So Rohit, what happened to you? Is it working now?
Ma'am, I downloaded it again.
Yeah.
But still it doesn't show.
I think then we'll ask Mark only tomorrow. If you, I can give you his email and if you want.
I'll just try to show you my screen 1 minute because I've opened Zoom on my mobile. Just one. No.
In fact, it's working even in Windows. There's no problem.
Yeah, I don't. And this is something very basic. You know, there could be some specialized features which don't work. But I don't see why this should be a problem. Anyway, we can ask him and you can personally contact him and check the
problem. Okay, ma'am, I'll do that.
And then if you have an iFi system also, I've used it on much earlier ones.
Okay.
The older one, have you deleted that? Removed it from my system. How do you know that now when you are running it, you are running the new one which you have downloaded now?
And not the old one.
Yeah. Yeah, make it big. You can see.
Okay. Yeah, okay, so fine. So now click on the histogram thing, then what happens? Rohit, can you click on the histogram link and check?
Yes, ma'am. It doesn't show anything.
Okay. No, then we'll just ask him. Like sir is saying, convince yourself that your old TopCat has been deleted.
Okay.
So actually, TopCat old versions also, since the past 10 years or whatever, it's working since a long time. So even if you have an older version, I don't see why it won't work.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very reliable piece of code.
And then if your scatter plots are working and other...
His no plots are working. Your scatter plot is not working. Scatter plot is not working, no? Yeah, click on that. Yeah, click. Click the scatter, huh? Click that. And does it pop up, the thing?
No, ma'am, nothing.
See, then there is a problem.
I think your pop-ups are disabled. Probably you check your pop-up.
Probably.
You do that, pop-ups are probably disabled in your case.
Okay.
Yeah. Whoever this is may be right.
But ma'am, when I do this, for example, go to graphics, you can see the screen?
Yeah, I can see.
Yeah, if I go to graphics and I go to this 2D old plot. See this.
Very good. So
this shows.
Then your pop-up problem is not there. Then I think we'll ask Mark. If you want, I can forward you his email. And you can ask them.
Hey, you better...
Okay, ma'am. But this doesn't work. See, if I go to graphics.
Yeah.
I do this histogram, the new one.
Yeah.
This doesn't work. Even though if I go to the old one, if I go to graphics, I do histogram plot old. So even this doesn't work.
Okay.
One minute. It is open. You have to select.
See, what is your just see your x-axis. See that drop-down menu, you have no access where you've got call one. Click something else. Click over there. Yeah. Go to call two. Achha, upar just click on that plot rescale. Rescale, there's a rescale. Or an access, it's a rescale. One of them has a rescale. Which one has
it?
It's okay. Only the data, the range which you have by default.
So that's why. So click on plot and click on rescale. Isn't there a rescale?
Yeah, configure access and title.
So just you know your values, no? So put your x values just accordingly. Are you out of range? Your range is 0 to 1, na, for some reason?
I'll just do, for example, for the test file.
No. So your test file, what are your values in your test file? If you're using this for M3, it will not work because your range is only 0 to 1, na?
And no, I'm using it for the test file.
Okay. And what are the test file? That same 112439.
Yeah. It's the same thing that as you told me.
But then this will also not do, na? Because your x is ranging from 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
And here you have your x is only -1 to 1. So change your click on axis and rescale. No, upper, you have axis. So now keep your x ranging from 0 to 5. And apply.
Doesn't show. I've tried it before. This access one.
But see, I think that now this is not a software issue because it is running. It is coming. So it's not that your histogram is not running. It's not displaying. And the display. Acha, what about your your y-axis also? What's your range? I can't see. What's your y-axis range? Change that also, na?
Open your table.
Show me your test table. Show your test table. What is it? 1, 1, 2, 4, 3, 9, 4, 16. Okay. So now go back to the histogram thing and show me the y-axis of your histogram. I can see some decimal values, na?
It's not changing actually.
No. Go click on axis. No, click on axis, and you can range it. Okay, this is flip. But okay, this is the older version, na?
Yeah.
Okay, one minute. Then I'll just check this thing.
Oh, this plot has to configure axis and title. Just 1 minute.
Or like I told you, huh? Or there's a rescale wala button.
Why axis I plotted from 1 to 20?
Why 1 to 20?
You have to.
It won't, na? See. The occurrence is happening only once, na? One is happening once, two is happening once, three is happening once.
Yeah.
So one can go in the this thing, na? So you should say 0 to 2, for example.
Okay.
Because everything is occurring only once. Histogram is counting how many times this thing is occurring.
Okay. And the x-axis range will be from same
0 to 5. Because you have 1 to 4, na? So take 0 to 5.
It doesn't change.
No, but you see, your display is not changing. Okay, just show me the new histogram. Close this thing. And show me the new histogram. When you... No, the down. Use the down icon. No, use the normal icon. Okay, use this. Click.
It doesn't open.
So now check that pop-up story or click this. It doesn't pop up.
No, even the scatter one. It doesn't.
Okay, then I'll just check on it. We can ask him.
Which version of the, you are using Ubuntu or? Go ahead.
Yes, sir.
Which version of Ubuntu are you using?
19.
That's enough.
Okay, so one thing is you can always check on the net and say that Ubuntu this thing is not working. So if there are some issues, people will respond to that.
Okay, so I'll try doing that today.
We'll check up on your thing, don't worry, we'll check.
Yes.
Okay. What about the others? Do you all have any questions? John, I can see John is there. Who else is there? Who are the others? Do we have more questions from the others? See, the advantage is this is a smaller session, so you know we can handle 10 of you all. Otherwise, we can't handle so many.
know how to save the subset as a file, separate file.
Ah, okay. So as a separate file, if you want to save it, I'll show you. So so you can see my screen, right? Can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Ah, so now this is my file, right? So then I put row subset, you write the name. Supposing my row is CPM, okay?
Yes,
now you click on file and you say save. Now you actually Topcat lets you save a whole session. So if I even made many subsets and I want to keep them all, I can even save it as a session. But otherwise, if I want to save as a table, I've clicked on this, I can say save table. But you should have clicked the subset you wanted, okay? Otherwise, it will save the whole table. And again, click whatever format you want and whatever location, and that's it. But see, so it will let you, you can actually save a whole session. Save the current table, save multiple tables also if you want, and save the whole session with its subsets. You can save everything, okay? Because otherwise, that was a major thing people requested of Mark Taylor, that if you work on it for 1 hour, then again, everything is lost in case you reboot, right? So like I used to never reboot my system only, so everything is there. But otherwise, so you can save it, right? But don't forget that you should select your CPM over here. Otherwise, it will save the file as it is. It won't save the subset. Okay? Or like I said, save the whole session. Then it will save all the subsets. Yeah, next, is there anybody else who has any question? Who else is there? I can't see the chat window. Let's make.
Ma'am, is there a way to save once you, for example, like we looked at M3 data today, yeah. And suppose I want to look at something else, and then yeah. Maybe tomorrow come back to the same data set.
Yeah.
But every time I will have to...
No. Once you've got this, save this M3 data on your local system, na? Okay. Then you don't need the net also. Then even without the internet, if you save it on your local system, then just open Topcat. Topcat doesn't need the net. Topcat yeah. only needs the net if you're using VO tools. For example, you're using the phone search, or we have not yet told you all how you can actually use a Topcat table to visualize it in something called Aladdin. We've not yet come up to Aladdin, which is a visualizing software also of VO. We'll be doing that soon later on. So, and for that also, we've got you the main people who are handling that software. They will be talking to you all. And so that actually gives you the image, okay? So you have to, you save all these files with you locally. You don't have to this thing. I showed you an M3 from Topcat to just show you how can you query and get data using Topcat itself. Like I told you, there are many more ways of getting it, but Topcat is one of the ways of getting it. Okay. Fine. So is there any other question? Or can you see the chat window or something? Are there any more questions?
Any more questions?
Does everybody, okay.
Suppose we have values for B filter, V filter, and R filter, and I want to do arithmetic, I want to subtract B minus V. And
okay.
How can we do that?
Yeah, so it's very simple. So here, for example, M3 I have, this is my table, right? Look at your table and just right click at the header file. Right click and you say new synthetic column. Okay, so I may call the new synthetic column as new. Now the expression which you have to do is, for example, if I put the new just equal to deg, that means this is the deg wala or the RA wala column, then it is just going to do me my RA, right? But I can define my new column to be, for example, so you can either do this, or like in this, I can right click and I say replace the column. So now I'll say my new column is not RA. It is, for example, RA minus, what was the center? 205.5, supposing, right? So I put that. So now you can see my column is this. This is RA minus this. So similarly, you can do all kinds of math operations. You can see over here, there's an fx. Fx is telling you what are the mathematical functions you can do with TopCat. So for example, you can take the logs, you can take, you may convert it to some other units. If they are degrees, you may convert it to radians, you may convert it to fluxes, you may take logs, you may do whatever you want. So these are all the available functions, okay? So with fx, you can choose whatever available functions you have. And with that, you can define whatever new column you want based on these arithmetical functions, which cover almost everything we need. There's nothing you need which is not there on that. So for example, yeah, so the other one is, for example, you were asking, you know, so for example, if I want this to be equal to RA minus DEC, it doesn't make any sense, but I'm just doing that. So that will give me this. So this is my new column, which is RA minus DEC. Okay. I can even name this. I can name the column instead of calling it new. I may call it RA minus DEC. So you could have called it B minus V or whatever that you wanted, right? So in that way, you can do arithmetical operations between columns. If you don't remember the column name also, you can replace it by, for example, dollar, just dollar. So this one is dollar one, dollar two, dollar three, dollar four. Accordingly, you can do it. So I can even put it as, I can put it as dollar one minus dollar two. I can also replace it like column 1 multiplied by 5 minus column 2 multiplied by 0.05, right? So like I said, all arithmetical operations can be done, whatever you want. Nodalini, does that answer your question?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Yeah, okay. See, these are all essential things, because then when you are doing something of data analysis, you have to do those things. And TopCat helps a lot, because if in advance you plot it and you see how it looks in TopCat, na, then you can make your other plots more beautiful plots. But before that, if you're trying to just visualize and see what is giving you something meaningful, TopCat is very, very helpful. I think I'm using it for the past 10, 15 years. It's very, very useful. It's very good.
See, the basic idea of this course is that we want to show you the things which we have learned the hard way. In earlier times, you had to write programs to read data, to multiply, subtract columns, all kinds of things. Now there are a lot of very useful tools available which you can use very easily and effectively and do it. And so that you can jumpstart and get into your work, we thought we should do this. Because getting to know that such things are possible, such tools are available, at least we have spent a lot of time understanding this. So, yeah, so this is the basic idea. Use it and see what you want to do, and accordingly keep improvising on. There's a lot of these tools are extremely versatile and very useful.
I mean, these are like, you know, walking steps. Later on, you'd make more sense of it, right? Okay. So who has more questions? Rohit, I'm sorry, your thing is not yet solved. But is there a browser-based TopCat? Maybe you can run that. I'll just check.
I'll try doing that, ma'am. Maybe I'll try downloading it again. Let me see what happens.
Because it's a very strange problem you have. I'm sorry, but I've never seen such a mistake.
Yeah, even I have 90.01 or some version of Ubuntu, and there's no such problem there.
Yeah, I mean, it must be some small thing.
But yeah. I did install it from command line. So you better delete what you had installed earlier and okay. See that you are running the program which you are downloading it from the web page and doing it. And download the full version.
Yes, I'll do that. Thank you.
Yeah. So anybody else, please write in the chat window. I can see who else is there. Julie, Sriram, John, Hasibul, Sushil. Do you all have any doubts, questions? See, this session basically we are doing is that we are trying to get you all some of you know, the key people in different projects of VO so that they can speak to you and you can ask questions. So even the following Saturday, we have Luisa Ribul, who's in Caltech, and she handles the infrared database, the IPAC. So Luisa will be in the morning, we'll do the session with a recording that Luisa has sent us. And in the night, we'll have the Q&A with her. So you'll get some time to understand that and then ask her questions in the night. Similarly, even for, there is a Center for Astronomy Data in Strasbourg in France. Even they have also given us a video which we are going to do for Aladdin and for CDS. So with a Q&A session which we'll have after that. So we are trying to do this so that, you know, you all can get in touch with the key people who are behind these projects, right? Because they are the ones who know it all inside out. So try to make the best of it tomorrow. And like we said, these are just stepping stones. Because the thing is finally of running it to an efficiency where you're getting a certain purpose, right? With TopCat also, for example. So you need to get comfortable with the different things with it, right?
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Yeah, when I open my terminal window,
yeah,
and then I run TopCat, so it, can you see the terminal window?
Where?
Ma'am?
I can't see anything, Krishna, sorry.
Ah,
I can see it.
You can see it? So it shows failed to load module Canberra-GTK module.
So maybe you, you have to probably download some more libraries.
Okay.
Just Google and see what is that thing. What is that Canberra thing? I don't know. But just check, that could be some, okay.
GTK module. Yeah, yeah.
Canberra GTK module. So just say na, install Canberra GTK module or something like that.
Okay, I'll try to do that.
Or you copy and paste this error
on the net. You will find some solution.
Okay, ma'am.
But maybe some supporting libraries are not there. The TopCat page, does he, I can see his page just now. Has he listed what are the libraries you need? Documentation. Okay. So just go through his main page. He has some.
And things. Sometimes with these new releases of Linux and all, there are some issues which crop up because they are careful about bundling up the libraries and other things. So obviously, whenever you're using a newer version, you go through a stage of redoing, retesting, reinstalling certain libraries.
And
so it's sometimes safer to use an older one where people have tried and settled all the issues and then things work fine.
See, he says you should have Java's web start installed. So just check if you have Java's web start.
Java?
Web start. WebStart. And I hope you've downloaded the standalone jar file.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, okay. So there is one, what is it called? Full start Java installation, which is there on his web page, you just see. So he says you can run here. I think it's just some libraries which you need. Okay, what about the rest? The rest, please tell us if you all have any questions or doubts.
Ma'am, is it possible?
Yeah.
Is it possible for us to run TopCat online? No, I think, right?
Yeah, yeah. So I am actually checking that out, that because I was seeing that for Rohit.
Yeah,
it doesn't seem to have
online.
Yeah, like Aladdin, for example, you can run it from the browser.
And I was looking for it also. And one thing I don't know, is it possible for us to save any pictures of Aladdin? No, right?
Yeah, you can save. Bilkul, you can save it.
Okay.
On Aladdin, you click on file and save, and it will give you the choice of what format and all that. You can save it. Not a problem. You can save.
This was so beautiful.
I said you are to save it, right? How will you manage if you cannot save it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Okay, I will look.
So you can save it in even PITS format, so that you can do further analysis with it. Yes, you can save.
Ma'am, another.
And actually, what we have not done about is that these things even talk to each other. There's a SAMP protocol with which all these VO tools talk to each other. So you can do it like that too. Okay, go on, ask.
Ma'am, we were doing the cone search thing in TalkBack, right? But yeah. after cone search, there is something called simple image access, SIA.
Yeah, try them all out. There's not one way of doing things. There are many ways of doing things. I just showed you a sample way. So you can explore and see. There are slight differences, slight advantages in whatever. Cone search is very simple. That's why I showed that to you. But you're welcome to check the other ones. Okay. Check all of them.
A word of advice for the others who have not been interacting. See if there are some people who are asking and trying. Probably they have worked with astronomy data and they are familiar with it. So don't get disheartened.
Yeah, the others who are sitting quiet and not talking.
So some people have already done a little bit of astronomy and stuff. And those who have not done earlier, you'll have to work a little harder and catch up with them. So don't get discouraged. These people probably are putting more efforts to learn, try, and make with you. It's important to get into problems. That's only when you learn. So there are many who are sitting quiet. Please don't get disheartened. Yeah, this is how we learn.
So can I add something to this?
Yeah.
I can talk about myself, and I never did this before, and I was facing problems even with downloading the thing. So those who are not speaking or just hiding themselves, nothing to hide, because ma'am or sir won't kill us, right?
No, I mean, it's not that we know everything. That's why we are getting other people also to talk to you, because everybody has expertise in something or the other. Nobody knows everything. So it's okay. Even we don't know many things. So that's fine. Right? So that is just to encourage the ones who are sitting quiet. Please speak up. Because if you speak up and interact, you will learn. If you don't do that, you will have confusion in your mind, which will never get cleared up. Right? So please, speak. That would be nice.
Okay, so if there's nothing more to discuss, shall we close the session today?
Yeah, and Telegram is open. So you all can, whatever, message in case there's anything, right? Is that fine? Say yes.
Yes, ma'am, that's okay.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Yeah, and we are there, so you can post whatever. And tomorrow, so we meet at tomorrow 10 o'clock. And
okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Ma'am, if there is any problem regarding this installation, so I'll put it on Telegram.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Okay. Bye.